Yo, what's good YouTube? It's your boy Vexified back with another 2K video. So today's video, I got y'all another glitch video, and this is a VC glitch video. Now, I'm gonna just say this right now, like, I'm not doing this glitch myself. So if y'all do get banned, it's not, don't come to me, don't talk about me about it, because it's not my responsibility. I'm just posting the tutorial on y'all, or for y'all, how to do the glitch, right? I'm posting the tutorial on how to do the glitch, right? And I'm not gonna even be doing the tutorial. The person that's gonna be doing the tutorial is the great Densky. So I will link his channel in the description below, but he will be showing y'all how to do the glitch, obviously, all right? Now, this works on PS4 and Xbox, by the way. So make sure y'all go ahead and, you know, just do it while y'all can. But again, do this at your own risk. If y'all get banned, don't come to this video and start commenting, all right? And I'm pretty sure, I'm like 90% sure that you're not gonna get banned, because 2K really doesn't ban people like that if you're not like a big YouTuber or anything. But yeah, so anyways, I'm just get straight into the video, not waste any time, and yeah.
So there was an update the other day, and I got a couple of updates for y'all regarding this badge glitch, which is now also one of the best VC methods in the game. Now, I was aware that a lot of y'all were being placed on the same team or not having a controller on each team. Now, simply put, how I do this is I choose the NBA Today game that's on my mic career that day, and then I go to the team that I'm playing on, and I put the controller on the team that I'm playing against. You know what I'm saying? So whatever controller I'm playing on, that's the side I'll go to, and the other controller, I'll put it on the other team. It's that simple. After that, you would just change the settings to a rookie or Hall of Fame, however you want to play it on. It doesn't matter, because it's going to be no defense, no offense. And then you join one of your friends park, and then you go to My Player Nation and you start a game, and then you should be controlling both teams in my career. In the meantime, I know a lot of y'all was asking me a good VC glitch or a good VC method. Now, I will go ahead and tell y'all this is the best VC method in the game thus far, simply because they have heavily nerfed VC you get for endorsements, my career, and all game modes in this game this year. It used to be much higher when the game first came out, so it's easier to get VC, but now it's not as hard. But starting it off, if you're doing this for VC, my approach is to get 5 fouls as quick as possible. Now, since you're controlling both teams, it's nothing to just go down there and run and foul the other team, because you don't have to chase them down, run after them. They're not going to hit shots, shoot shots, and you're not going to waste time getting fouls. You know how sometimes you try to foul the computer, they'll be running around, they might take some shots, they might pass the ball, and you're running around trying to chase the other team. Now, when you get the ball, I just pretty much try to get some stats on my character. So I try to get like 10 points, you know what I'm saying, just to make sure that I'll get some VC, because if you're not in the game long enough, you will not get VC after the game. Now, the reason I like doing it in My Player Nation is because you get double VC. Now, I am sure that you can do this with your main character as well in regular My Career. I'm sure it'll still work. But my only thing is when I make a new character and I get my 6th foul in the second half. Now, I do know you have to play a certain amount of minutes. Now, that minutes that I got it down to was 6. Now, it could be 5, but after 6 minutes, I did get VC. And that's 6 minutes of you being in the game. So that's like a quarter and then 1 minute of another quarter in My Career. Now, also, I'm telling y'all that because when I first tried this, I got like 10 points and I fouled out. My player had like 3 minutes of gameplay in like the first quarter or the first half, and he did not get any VC after the game. So make sure you try to get like 6 minutes and some stats. And when I was able to get my 6th foul in the second half, I was able to get my VC. Now, this is another thing to keep in mind. If you have a new player now, if you make a new player today, the VC per game you get is 500. So if you double that, it's going to be 1,000. Now, if you did that beforehand, you made a new player, you would get 750 VC starting off. So they nerfed the VC starting my career by 250 VC, because like I told y'all, they cut down on VC in almost every single game mode that on this game in an attempt to get more money out of people, in an attempt to get more people to buy VC. Because when the game came out, as long as you were playing my career, as long as you were playing in the park, stacking up VC was relatively easy this year, you know what I'm saying? But now it's gotten a little bit more difficult, so I'm coming to y'all with the most useful glitch for VC. Now, if you already have a character in my career with a max VC salary contract, now that means you're gonna be getting over 1,000 per game without the double VC with My Player Nation. So with My Player Nation, you'll probably get like 2,000, maybe even close to 3,000, depending on your incentives and whatnot and how that works. So that would make the glitch even better if you have a main character and some other characters just for some extra VC. You know what I mean? If you just need some extra VC, this is a nice quick way to get some extra VC. Now, at the same time, if you really want to run it up, you could create multiple players, multiple fouls on different teams, or you can just create a foul each time that day with a team that's playing has a mod PlayStation game that day, you can get double VC on that character. But like I said, you start off at 500 now, no longer 750. So in that point, you'll get like 1,000 per game, per mod player. But if you do want to get more than 1,000 starting off, without having to go through a whole season and then renegotiate a contract. Because if you do go through a whole season and you can renegotiate a contract and your player's getting good stats, then you might can get a max contract depending. But I don't know how long that's going to take y'all, especially if y'all going out there with 60 overalls. Because if y'all need VC, then obviously y'all not going to want to invest in the characters y'all want to put in just for VC. Now, the good thing is if you actually play the prelude, you'll start off with more VC, maybe close to 1,000. So that means you'll get close to 2,000 VC per game for each My Player Nation game for each My Player you have. Now, getting through the prelude may take a little bit of time, but it can be well worth it if you're getting that much VC per game for 6 minutes. Because like I said, the more VC you're getting on your player, the more worthwhile doing the VC method this way is, because it's super easy. Like I said, you can control both teams, so you're not going to waste time fouling. You're not going to waste time going to the free throw line. You're not going to waste time just doing a lot of extra stuff. You can just shoot the ball, get the rebound, and go to the other side of the court. So even though you are playing 6 minutes, it is a faster 6 minutes than a regular My Career game. Now, this is important because, like I tell y'all, a lot of people are about to get the game new this holiday season. They're not going to have VC. And yes, previously the best way was to negotiate your endorsements to get 10,000 VC endorsements. And, you know, whenever you get those endorsements, your VC will stack up really quickly along with their incentives. But they nerfed that as well. So now you are no longer getting 10,000 endorsements unless you already have them on the My Player. Unless they nerfed them, unless they took them away and took them down on our current My Players as well. Because I know they have made it more difficult to get VC compared to when the game first started. So if you didn't have the game when it first started, you're almost at a disadvantage. Now, I will say that the only thing that they did do that was good was buff badge progression. But a lot of y'all have already missed some of the best badge glitches in the game. Even though what I'm showing y'all right here is a badge glitch as well, I will definitely link the best method for y'all to do this glitch. You know what I'm saying? To get as many stats as y'all want, or get a lot of crazy stats for points, rebounds, steals, assists, all that good stuff. But at this point, this is the best thing to do for VC. Even if you go to the ante up 1v1, you only get 500 VC per game that you win. And for some reason, 2K might even take some out of that from you. So that sucks as well. Now, you might get 1,000 for a rec game, but that's an entire rec game. You will get a little bit for some park games. You don't even get that much VC. I don't even know you get any VC for playing Play Now anymore, because I play Now a lot. People come over and play. And usually, you know, if you play a lot of Play Now games on your own console, if people come over and play a lot, that VC will add up as well. But that does not seem to be the case this year. So I took the time to narrow it down to see what would be best. And honestly, this would be best. You know what I'm saying? Coming in here, controlling both teams, getting your stats, running the clock, getting out of the game quick, and getting your double VC as fast as possible. Best VC method in the game right now. And I know this because nobody has really been posting anything legitimately better than this VC related, or anything VC related at all. Right now, everything, the wave has been badge glitches, rep, all the other stuff, mob points. You know, everybody has moved away, shifted away from VC, man. So, you know, I got to come here, switch it up, and show y'all something new. Now, I like to check my minutes by pushing pause. You can see it's at 5 minutes. I've been in the game 5 minutes, 10 points. Now, like I said, I went to six just to be safe. I did not necessarily try five because I knew that seven did work for me when I did it the other day. But I will come through for y'all. I will test that prelude part for y'all as well and show y'all that when you negotiate your prelude, you'll get more VC. And then you might get like 2 bands of VC a game. You know what I'm saying? Depending on what contract you can negotiate. Because y'all know I'm going to keep it real with y'all. The glitch could be okay. It could be good. It could be great. Depending on how many miles players you have. Depending on all their VC salaries, of course. Now, like I said, if you need quick VC, you can just make a quick my player or whatever has a game that day. You're going to get 500 per game. Double that, it's going to be 1,000. So that's a big advantage off top. If you're getting 1,000 per game compared to getting 500, that's literally double the VC, especially if you're just now getting the game or you don't have much VC and you need VC and you need to go to the park and you can't buy any. That is a huge advantage simply because you're getting more VC and you're saving time. Now imagine playing full My Career games for 500 VC salary. If you're looking at it like that from that perspective, you're going to be like, oh man, that's a lot of VC. That's a very good method to do. I tell y'all all the time, every glitch, every method isn't for everybody. If y'all already have VC, then a lot of y'all are going to be good. But like I said, this badge method is going to be good for everybody anyways because you can really stack up your badges really easily. Now, I also want to mention to y'all that I have heard in a badge glitch perspective, after a certain points of stats, your badge points or your my points cap out. I'm not sure how true that is, but I have heard that from a couple people. So I just want y'all to be aware that if you are doing this and going crazy with the badge glitch, And for some reason, your progress reaches a certain limit, even though your stats are way more than, and your progress should be more. That's probably why. Now, you can see I got my sixth foul when I was 6 minutes into the game. Team was up 12 points. I don't think it matters how much your team is up. As you can see at the end of the game, they're up 10 points. Like I said, the game doesn't automatically sim out. You have to sit on the bench or wait. Well, I mean, you do sim for the rest of the game, but you know what I mean. You don't just sim straight to the end. You kind of got to watch how the game unfolds. But other than that, you should be good. You can sit there, chill for the rest of the game. You know you're going to get some mind points and badge points. But like I said, most of y'all going to be doing this particular method for VC. There's the badge method. This is the VC method. Both of them are fire. Both of them are very useful. And y'all know I'm going to continue to look at ways to make it even better for y'all. And I will come through here and I will show y'all how to make this an even better VC method as it already is. As you can see, your VC goes up. You get 1,000. It's 2 times because it's based off 500, my player nation.